Ginkgo Bioworks is on CNBC's Disruptor 50 list for the fourth time. The company has had to pivot during the pandemic, or has chosen to pivot, focusing some of its efforts on the fight against COVID and partnering with companies like Roche and Moderna and Illumina. Joining us now, Jason Kelly, founder and CEO of Ginkgo Bioworks. Jason, do you have any employees, or does your chemical engineering and biological engineering PhD from MIT, do you just do all this yourself?
No, we have an amazing team at Ginkgo.
You could, I think. So I'll tell you what I see here, and that is we think of Ginkgo, or I did anyway, of using cell engineering to biologically create products for food or perfume or all these different uses using the most beautiful automated machinery in the world, obviously, because it's got 4 billion years of evolution, and it's the cell. But I'm trying to figure out how you applied that to dealing with COVID, and I guess you have developed high-throughput automated systems which will work for testing COVID. So it happens, what you've learned in other areas can apply to COVID. Have I got that right? Because I had to read it a couple of times.
Yeah, you have it right. I was going to say, you know, Joe, with your biology background, this is the, you know, biology meets business in the case of COVID here. So that's a good topic for you. Yeah.
So you've got Illumina's technology for next generation sequencing. So you're going to make a machine using that where you could do millions of COVID tests simultaneously very quickly.
Yeah. Amazing. Yeah, I mean, yeah, and just, you know, Ginkgo's about $4.5 billion market cap company focusing on programming cells, right? And we do that, as you mentioned, with a lot of automation. And back in March, we pointed the platform against COVID. And what we found was, you know, we're partnering with companies like Moderna to try to speed vaccine manufacture. And that's important. It's just going to take some time. And I think what people don't realize is there was a testing need in sort of the acute phase of the pandemic. Right? It was almost like a nuclear bomb went off and there was a shock wave. And we needed all these tests for people that were in the hospital and, you know, like just overwhelmed and this sort of heroic effort to scale testing, right? Well, now that's over. We all got out of our, getting out of our bunkers. We're trying to go back to work but there's fallout, right? And what we're waiting for is, oh, well, there'll be a vaccine to take that away. In my opinion, we need now screening-based testing, not diagnostic testing like in the hospital, but much more efficient, lower cost, workplace or university or other organization collected tests that say you don't have this. It's screened like you'd have a cancer screen. You don't expect you have it, but you want to check, right? And in my opinion, if we did that at large scale, that could end COVID-19 before a vaccine. I think it's actually the faster approach to getting after this if we really did it.
And you're actually building a place to do that, right?
We need new technologies to do it. Yeah, absolutely. So Ginkgo is going to be doing, we're basically building out robotic automation. We're using genome sequencers like you were used to sequence the human genome.
Right.
Now repurposing a machine like that, like a single washing machine size genome sequencer, would be able to do something like 50 to 100,000 tests a day if the techniques we're building work out.
And then it's just, that's what I mean. It's just looking at all the things you're doing, you're also trying to streamline the search for an antibody therapeutic, which your technology applies to as well, and to manufacture some of the components for the vaccine in a more, an easier and faster way for Moderna. So all in prior to this, before COVID, you were doing totally different things.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. So the way to understand this is the platform is general purpose,
right?
It's kind of like you have a PC at home, you can run all kinds of different apps on there. We have a platform that allows us to program cells for whether it's for Bayer in agriculture, Roche in pharmaceuticals, or now these challenges with COVID-19. And so, yeah, that flexibility is built into Ginkgo's business model.
I can imagine trying to do an interview like this. I'd really like to go to like a 4-hour seminar
Yeah, one thing I found that's interesting right now is every sort of leader of a business or, you know, dean of a university, mayors of a city, they all have exactly the same thing on their mind right now, which is how do I bring my workforce back safely? And so we launched today our testing platform, Concentric, which basically allows, you know, it's sort of an end-to-end process. It goes in and helps those people who are all right now trying to suddenly become, you know, novice epidemiologists and understand how do they contain outbreaks among their community of workers. Right. And it's partially a workplace safety issue, but it's also, Joe, a business continuity issue. right? You know, Tyson had to shut down 6% of the country's poultry production. Ford shut down the F-150 plant, right? You know, if you want to maintain your business during this fallout period, you need to have testing, right?
Yeah.
And the good thing is that's solvable at the scale of, you imagine like a university in the Northeast, well, small.
I wish we could talk longer. Did you go over to Koch at different times? Or it was called Center for Cancer Research long ago.
Yeah, at MIT. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Do you know Tyler Jacks? Did you know any of the?
Yeah, I did.
He's totally involved with all this stuff. Good man.
That's good, Jeff.
All right. Keep in touch, Jason. I'd like to talk to you again about this. I'm barely scratching the surface of understanding it, but thank you. Appreciate it.
Andrew. Thanks, Jeff. Yep. Good to chat.